Hello everyone, my name is Mayur Gohil and this is my third video lecture on Laplace transforms. So let us see today what are we going to do. We are going to find Laplace of t to the power n where n plus 1 is greater than 0. So for finding Laplace of t to the power n, I am going to go by definition. What is the definition of Laplace of f of t? It is nothing but integral 0 to infinity e raised to minus st times f of t dt. Further, since our function under consideration is t to the power n, wherever you are seeing f of t, you replace it by t to the power n. So we get this as our expression. Laplace of t to the power n is nothing but integral 0 to infinity e raised to minus st times t to the power n dt. In order to solve this integral further, I am going to use change of variable method. So what am I going to substitute is, this st is going to be replaced by m. So m is equals to st, therefore t is nothing but m upon s. Also we will get the value of dt is dm upon s. Okay, further, whenever we are doing the change of variable, we have to take care of the limits as well. So in order to take care of the limits, put t equal to 0 in this equation, therefore m is equals to 0, and put t is equals to infinity in this equation, you get m is equals to infinity. Therefore what do we obtain is nothing but the same limits, but the variable under consideration has changed. Thus, what do we obtain further is Laplace of t to the power n is nothing but integral 0 to infinity e to the power minus m. Now for t, you substitute it by m upon s, and dt will be substituted by dm upon s. Thus, now observe here, since m is the variable under consideration, whatever is other than this variable m would be treated as a constant. Whatever is the function of other than m would be treated as constant. So this variable s is constant. Hence what we can do is, we can pull this 1 upon s to the power n plus 1 outside. Thus we obtain integral 0 to infinity e to the power minus m times m to the power n dm. Okay. Now in order to evaluate this integral further, I recall a definition of a function known as gamma function from integral calculus. This function, gamma function or gamma of n, is given as integral 0 to infinity e to the power minus x times x to the power n minus 1 dx. Now in order to use this definition into our problem solving, I need to simplify it little bit further. So just observe, gamma n plus 1 is nothing but integral 0 to infinity e to the power minus x into x to the power n times dx. Okay, so what is this? Nothing but this integral is just same as this integral. Only change is, instead of variable m, we have variable x. But under integration, the variable under consideration is can be treated as a dummy variable. Thus, if we see, this integral is nothing but gamma n plus 1. Thus, what do I have is, Laplace of t to the power n is nothing but gamma n plus 1 upon s to the power n plus 1. Now we have a new formula for us. We can update this in our formula list and we can refer it as and when we need it. Now we move ahead. We are going to find Laplace of this function t to raised to 4 plus sine phi t minus cosine 3 t. If you have prepared the formula list, it would be very easy for you. Let us see how. Just consider the function. The Laplace of this function can be written as Laplace of t raised to 4 plus Laplace of sine phi t minus Laplace of cosine 3 t. What property allows us to do this is nothing but the linearity property of the Laplace operator L. We have already shown in our first video lecture that Laplace L operator is nothing but a linear operator. Further, we now know the formula for Laplace of t to the power n that we just derived. It is nothing but gamma n plus 1 upon s raised to n plus 1. Therefore, gamma n plus 1 is nothing but gamma of 4 plus 1, that is gamma phi, over s raised to 5, plus Laplace of sine a t. We are aware it is nothing but a upon s square plus a square, that is Laplace of phi t, sine phi t would be phi upon s square plus phi square would be 25. And further, Laplace of cosine 3 t is nothing but s upon s square plus a square, that is s upon s square plus 3 square, and 3 square would become 9. In this case, we get this as the answer. In order to simplify it further, you need not cross multiply the denominator and go for a complicated simplification. You just evaluate these terms little further. Gamma phi factorial, gamma of phi is nothing but 4 factorial, that is the formula is using gamma n plus 1 is nothing but n factorial for every n which is a natural number. So you just simplify this further, that you will get your final answer as 24 upon s raised to 5 plus 5 upon s square plus 25 minus s upon s square plus 9. Having done this, you are done with your solution of Laplace of t raised to 4 plus sine phi t minus cosine 3 t. Let us now further go to solve one more problem. We have to find Laplace of hyperbolic sine 3 t minus hyperbolic cosine 2 t. How can we do? The similar process is there. We have to consider the given question, and then you take Laplace on both the sides. Now over here, when you take Laplace, what happens? It distributes over minus sign, because Laplace operator is linear. And now you are aware regarding this formula, Laplace of hyperbolic sine at. If you have prepared the list, it is nothing but a upon s square minus a square, that is 3 upon s square minus 9, and hyperbolic cosine at would be nothing but s upon s square minus a square. And this is the way you solve it, and you simplify it easily. If you can simplify this term, it's okay. Otherwise, you can leave it as it is. You will get your mark over that. Okay, so that's it for today. Thank you.